Hey, thanks, Jim. Hey, we've all been there, right? So hungry, you're in a bad mood.
Yeah.
Right? We all know it. It's known as being hangry. We've got nutritionist Gisella Bouvier here with us this morning, getting us more on how we can prevent that hanger. Thanks so much for coming in this morning.
Thanks for having me.
So for the people at home that are like, hangry, I've never heard of this before. Can you tell us a little bit more about what that is?
So it's become quite the buzzword the past few years, and it's exactly what it sounds like. It's being hungry and angry at the same time.
Oh my goodness, that sounds like the worst feeling ever.
Yes.
How do you prevent that?
So what happens is there was a recent study that followed 64 people for 21 days. And then what they did was for 21 days, they recorded their emotional state and their level of hunger five times a day.
Okay.
And what researchers did realize was that when people are hungry, the more aggravated, irritable, and angry they become. So there was a 56% change in irritability and a 48% change in anger when people were hungry. Mm. So it doesn't necessarily, the research doesn't support that hunger equals anger, but I will tell you as a practitioner, if you're not nourished and running on empty, more likely you're going to be very hungry and then very angry.
Oh, sure. I mean, even on this shift, I've definitely been there where you finish the first couple of shows and you're like, I'm so hungry.
Yep.
I feel like a rhinoceros. I just want to like run through here.
Yeah, absolutely. So what you want to do is really help to prevent that that hanger state.
Yeah.
So you want to eat three meals a day and really start your day with breakfast. This may be counterintuitive for some people because some people are like, oh, I'm not hungry in the morning. But the thing is, by the time you realize you're hungry, you're in that hangry state. And it's probably when you're already stressed out and in kind of this emotional state. So you're just trying to like eat something to kind of cover and mask that hunger, but you're not finding any satisfaction. So you want to eat a breakfast, lunch, and dinner and really have complete meals. Include fiber, fat, and protein, those three elements, and include snacks as necessary, at least two of those elements. And that's really going to help to keep you fuller longer and find satisfaction. I also recommend that anytime you can eat mindfully to do so. Get away from all those stressors and anything that causes that anger so that you're able to regroup and unwind and really focus on your hunger and what you need to feel satisfied. It also really helps with your emotional state. A lot of times when we're stressed from work or just life in general, being able to find pleasure in food, because reality is if we're hungry and angry, those positive emotions are not going to be present. So we really just want to sit and unwind and enjoy our meal.
Absolutely. Those snacks go in between the meals.
Yes, absolutely. And include snacks as necessary. I'm definitely a snacker, I will say that. And it just helps to keep you fuller longer and also keep energy positive and keep you going.
Absolutely. Well, thank you so much for coming in this morning. I really appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Wonderful time. Hey, 9:25 is the time. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right back after this.